Atavara. I work as the gender focal point for Solidary Dead Network Asia, particularly with the Reaching the Unreached project. We are very happy to share this gender study report with you. So we wanted to make an assessment to document and to report to see how our interventions have had an impact on women and girls. And this study is a result of that. We have interviewed women and girls from 24 locations, and we have got their insights into the project. And it's very encouraging to know that that has had a positive impact on girls and women, especially in the nutrition areas and also in the menstrual hygiene management areas. So this is really an achievement as well as an inspiration to the Reaching the Unreached project team. The findings have been very useful for us, very encouraging, but as well as it also gives us some directions, pointers to strengthen and improve our interventions, which we will be doing within the next few months. So thank you very much for everyone who has been supporting this study, and we hope you will enjoy reading this, and it will be a useful learning process for you. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Mufliha Maharov, and I'm working as a social media and project dissemination consultant in the RTU project. I was able to observe that women and girls were lacking access to use digital media, especially phones, due to poor connection. Also, these women and girls are still using type of clothes despite of menstrual hygiene fact, because there are no any other choices for them, as they are unable to afford for pads or there are disposal issues. More like, they were really reluctant to talk about menstrual hygiene and sanitation topics. As an observation impact, provision of incinerators in the schools made more school days and more working days to move forward with more opportunities. Thank you.
Hi, this is Saranga Jayaratna. I'm a freelance gender consultant, and I am the principal researcher of this study. My task was to assess 8 gender indicators in this project, which is Reaching the Unreached. So we interviewed around 100 participants, including women CBO leaders and female students aged between 13 to 16. So we try to cover all the project areas. Amidst all these challenges, I'm really happy that we were able to complete the research successfully, and the results are really promising, I would say. Just to mention few, so we noticed, based on the analysis, we noticed that the women's leadership in grassroots decision making bodies has improved to a greater extent as a result of project intervention, and also the intake of nutritious food within families has improved again to a greater extent, thus improving the nutrition level of children and women especially.